you, Gray. Come in. Have a glass with me.
You're uncommon friendly tonight, Toddy. More like the old days.
I want someone to talk to. That fatty that you was all taken up with the widow never came back here. Gray, you know something about the human body?
I've had some experience.
Then you can understand this. The backbone is a lot of little blocks. And those blocks are all held together so that it works. Works like that whip of yours. You know that, don't you?
I've never had it all explained by so learned a man.
I set those blocks together, patch the muscles, put the nerves where they should be. I did it and I did it right. She won't walk.
Oh, it's the bit of a girl Fettes was talking about.
The same. Look here, Gray. I fitted them together like this, so that it was right. Yet she won't walk.
You can't build life the way you put blocks together, Toddy.
What the devil are you talking about? I'm an anatomist. I know the body. I know how it works.
You're a fool, Toddy, and no doctor. It's only the dead ones you know.
I am a doctor. I teach medicine.
Like Knox taught you? Like I taught you? In cellars and graveyards? Did Knox teach you what makes the blood flow?
The heart pumps it.
Did he tell you how thoughts come and how they go and why things are remembered and forgot?
The nerve centers, the brain.
What makes a thought start?
The brain, I tell you, I know.
You don't know, and you'll never know or understand, Dolly. Not from Knox or me would you learn those things. Look. Look at yourself. Could you be a doctor, a healing man with the things those eyes have seen? There's a lot of knowledge in those eyes, but no understanding. You'd not get that from me.
I am a doctor, I tell you, a good doctor. I could make her walk, but she won't. She won't.
Here, have another glass, McFarland, and I'll take you safely home and we'll be friends again. Now that you know that you're Knox's man and my friend, I forever.
I'm my own man, and I'll have no more to do with you, Gray. Why should I be afraid of you? What are you holding over me?
I'll tell you what. I stood up in the witness box and took what should have been coming to you. I ran through the streets with the mud and the stones around my ears and the mob yelling for my blood because you were afraid to face it. Yes, and you're still afraid.
No, I'm not afraid. Tell. Shout it from the housetops, but remember this. They hang Burke, they mobbed Hare, but Dr. Knox is living like a gentleman in London.
Aye. There's something in what you say, Toddy.
There is much in what I say, Gray. And if you have any regard for your neck, you leave now. And stay away from my house, my school, and from me.
Well, I've no wish for a rope cravat. I never liked the smell of him, so I'll bid you good night, Dr. McFarland.